I Thank you. Well, good evening, families. We'd like to welcome you to our Erdmann Winter Concert. This evening, we have the privilege of hearing the beautiful voices of our 4th and 5th grade chorus members. Students, I'm going to take this opportunity to let you know just how proud of you we are. It's so good to see you on stage. Family, can we give a round of applause for being here? Parents, we also want to take this opportunity to thank you for just being here and encouraging your students to participate in this extracurricular activity. It's no secret that we've been through a lot over these past couple of years, and to give an opportunity for our students to be a part of something like this is great. And when in dark times, giving our students the opportunity to sing and be happy, what a privilege that we're able to provide our students as a result of your support, and we really appreciate it. So the students, can you give your parents a round of applause, please? I'm also going to give another special shout out. I'm going to do this in the beginning because at the end it'll be a little crazy if you have to give it out. I want to give a special shout out to Mr. Lawson right now for all of you. I'm sure your students come home after practice and they tell you all the fun and exciting things that happen at rehearsals. He does such a great job at getting our students excited to sing the performances. So tonight's students, it is all about you. We can't wait to hear you perform. And then at this time, families, if you could please join me by standing and removing your hats and facing the flag here. Our chorus members are at the end of tonight's performance with stars and men. Thank you.
Thank you. by justice, and by peace. This song will feature Olivia Rosen as the soloist. Enjoy!
Enjoy.
awesome and a round of applause. It's a great show. One of the things I enjoy most about this evening's show is that the students were able to perform a song that they were planning to perform in third grade, and we were unfortunately not able to have that concert. And it was such a great way for this group to finally have their chance to perform a song they didn't have a chance. I'm so glad that they had the opportunity to do that. To put on a show like this evening took a lot of work. I want to take this opportunity to thank some very special people, because I know we're going to have an audience switch. But this event would not have been possible without the district leadership, Dr. Yenderman, and our assistant superintendent, Dr. Johnson, as well as our amazing technology department who set everything up and has everything live streamed so fans at home can see this event live. So, want to give an opportunity to thank this event. Can you join me and give a round of applause? At this time, we're preparing for our transition. We're going to have students who are in our band get prepared to perform. Our families were here just for the chorus concert. I've asked them to listen to my directions so we can make sure we get you to your children so that you can come safely. At this time, all the students are making their way down to our high school cafeteria. If you were here for the chorus portion of our performance, we're going to ask you to exit out of the right there, Mrs. Lewis, to open it up for you. And we're going to escort you down to the cafeteria where your children are waiting so you can go ahead and take them home. If you are staying for the band portion, you may have a seat or get a better seat. We'll have a few more audience members join us. Thank you so much for coming out and see you all soon. Thank you.
I
Good evening again, everyone. Thank you so much for coming out this evening to see our band in performance. This is such a great opportunity to share the Villa group that is great to be back in person for these performances. Probably one of the most challenging things I think any band teacher probably had to do is to find a way to take every single student playing an instrument in a little box and stripping them all together for it to sound like it makes sense. Mr. Benton did that for the past 2 years, as well as other members of our music department. So for that, we're grateful to be here this evening to see the performances of our dance band. I want to take this opportunity to thank all of you as well for your support. I know a lot of your kids drop off and went for their rehearsals, and probably a lot of the past couple years listening to them play those instruments. If you knew from the beginning, from last year, you heard what it sounded like. One of the best parts about being part of this process is just learning and watching how much your children grow through the years. So I listened to what they sounded like last year at this time, and now it's cool to see what they sound like this year at this time. And in the spring, we'll get the culmination of all of their hard work through the years to see what they sound like. But without any further ado, I would like to introduce to you our fourth and fifth grade dance band, led by Mr. Penn. Thank you once again for coming out.
As Dr. McLaurin mentioned, it was a challenge. I'm sure many of you went through the same challenges that I did, just on the other end. You probably even heard me in the background trying to say, okay,
take your clarinet, now put it together, no, this way, and put it together that way.
Okay, just go watch YouTube. And then they kind of figured it out. So our first selection that you just heard was Eric Mobility. They did an amazing job working on that song. Like, I gave my percussionists a little time to switch. We had four of them back there, and they needed to do a multitude of the percussion instruments back there, so it's really cool. They had a really cool opportunity to experience a lot of those things. And our second selection tonight is Adventure in India. This song transports you into a Bollywood scene. The music kind of mimics like what a Bollywood soundtrack would sound like. There's a lot of percussion that happens in this song, including our timpani, our snare drums. We have some congas back there that kind of emulate some of the Indian drums that you may hear in Bollywood song. So without further ado, we're going to play for you Adventure in India after our tune our timpani. every concert there's like a favorite selection that the kids like to play the most. A lot of them, I would say, really loved playing Adventure in India, unless, of course, you had one of the parts that just kept going dun, 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 over and over again. They're like, Mr. Band, why do I have to keep playing the same note over and over again? I say, that's the way it goes in band sometimes. Sometimes you play the same thing over and over again. Sometimes you get the melody, unless you play the trombone, then you never get the melody. So, but trumpets over there, they always get the melody. Flutes always getting the melody. So at this time, I'd like to recognize those sections a little bit. Maybe you can see them pretty well from where you are, but we're gonna start over here with our high woodwinds, our flute sections, and go ahead, stand up and give them a nice round of applause. All right, nice, I like the poses. All right, and then we're gonna move over to our other woodwinds, our squibworths of the band. It's our clarinet section. And then we're gonna move to the loud people in the band. Sorry if they pick saxophone and they're in your household. Here are saxophones. It's funny, they get really offended when I say that they play really loud. Like, we don't play loud. And it's like, oh, you kind of do, but. And then we're gonna move over to our brass section. We're gonna start first with our trumpets. Careful, those are expensive. Then we're gonna go over to our low brass section, our trombones. And then we're gonna move over to our smaller section. Well, they're not that small, but there's not very many of them. It's our French horns. Uh-oh. Okay, and then we're gonna go back to our percussion section. They're gonna stand, oh wait, they're standing. They're gonna wave. All right, the next, our last selection is entitled Freedom Finale. Every year with this band, I prepare a patriotic song, and we usually do a assembly for the veterans that come into the school for Veterans Day. This year we did a little taping. You may have seen that video. But it's a really nice event that we have that we can get together a patriotic song and then play for the veterans that come and visit our school. So I hope you enjoy Freedom Finale. Thank you very much for coming out. I just want to do a couple of quick thank yous. First and foremost, thank you to Dr. McLaurin and Ms. Mack. They've been super, super supportive of this whole process, so give them a round of applause. I'd also like to thank Dr. Mary Jo Yannicone and Dr. Damian Johnson. Without their support also, we wouldn't be able to have these live concerts, so give them a nice round of applause. And sitting right back there, he's gonna have his concert right after ours. There's Mr. Chuck Gottesman, our department coordinator. Give him a nice round of applause. Thank you very much. I'm gonna turn it over to Dr. McLaurin, and he's gonna close us out here and give us a little instructions. They're all going to pack up. I'll close the curtain, and then you can have an opportunity to meet them in the lobby after they pack up from the Freeze lobby back there.
Can we give Mr. Benton another round of applause? Thank you. And our students, can we show them some more love? Good job, students. Great job. So proud of you. Families, thank you so much for coming out this evening. Also want to give a special shout out to, once again, our technology department for live streaming this event at home. Want to thank our high school team for allowing us to use this beautiful space. For those of you who've been with us in the past, we used to have this assembly in our gym. It just doesn't sound as good. So we appreciate our high school team allowing us to be here and enjoy their space this evening. At this time, this does conclude our winter concert. Want to thank you all for coming out and for your continued support. Our students are going to pack up all their things and leave, and then we're going to meet them up in the Freeze lobby where they'll gather all those things. We do need to leave this space because the high school concert will be starting shortly after. And so we're gonna have you exit out of the doors where Mrs. Boyle's standing there once again. And your children will be able to meet you up in the lobby area where they'll have their instruments and you can go ahead and take them home. Thank you so much for coming out this evening and safe travels on your way back. Thank you.
I'm a little high. Give yourself a little pull compared to everybody else who's a little high. And Barron's to you guys. You're,
good evening. My name is Chuck Rittenhouse, and I'm the proud principal of Springfield Township High School. It is my pleasure to welcome you tonight to our annual winter concert. This evening will be the band concert. Last week we enjoyed the choral concert. For those in the audience, this concert is being streamed via our school district's YouTube channel. To those watching at home, welcome. To eliminate waste and sharing of paper programs, we are using an online concert program this evening. You look on the walls here. If you scan the QR code posted around the room with your phone, that link was also sent home. You'll be directed to our online program that lists the selections and the students involved in tonight's performance. I'd like to acknowledge and thank the families and guardians for supporting our students and our wonderful music program. And now for a commercial break. Our spring musical, The Little Mermaid, will be held on March 10th, 11th, 12th, and 13th. I'd like to acknowledge and thank the following individuals for their support of our music program. The Board of School Directors, Dr. Yannicone, our superintendent, Dr. Johnson, our assistant superintendent, Mr. Joe Ferrara, athletic director, Mr. Pierre LaRocco, assistant principal, and he's running around here. He is key to the evening. He tapes the seats off, he spaces everybody out. He's worked with the technology department, making sure we can stream this, has really been kind of the person behind the scenes helping out everything tonight, and I really appreciate all of his efforts with our program. Dr. Scott Sprague, assistant principal. Mr. Chuck Gottesman, our K-12 music coordinator. Mr. Steve Chinta, supervisor of campus safety and operations. Mrs. Thornton, drama director. And up in the booth up there, very important, Mr. Tim Coughlin, technical support, and Mr. Josh McKeel. We appreciate everything, getting the stream out and working on the lights and sound. A huge thank you goes out to Chuck Gottesman, our band director, and Andrew Puntel, our choral director, for their inspiration and efforts in regards to the development of our town and musicians. Students, this night is about you. It represents a culmination of all your practices, sacrifice, and hard work. Have a great night, and thanks for playing for us this evening. To all, I say, enjoy the concert. Mr. Gottesman.
Thank you very much, Dr. Rittenhouse, and thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome to the stage with me, after a two-year hiatus, we're going to welcome the STHS Symphonic Band. That feels good. That feels a lot better than putting little videos in boxes, I promise you that. One more round of applause for these outstanding musicians. I'm very proud of you. Thank you. So that was called A Night on Bald Mountain, a pretty popular piece of music from the classical genre by Modest Mussorgsky. We actually prepared that piece back in the early part of the semester, and we did it in the hallways the day before Halloween, just to sort of get everybody in the spirit and remind everybody here at Springfield that we've got a band that's working hard and learning lots of music. So we're going to go on with another selection that actually we were preparing for the holidays. We did some holiday hallway performances as well on the 23rd of December, the half day. We set up out in the hallways and we did some holiday selections. This piece is more commonly known as O Come Emmanuel, but this arrangement uses the Latin Veni, Veni, Emmanuel, and it's a really lovely piece that we hope you enjoy. It's definitely appropriate for all seasons. We hope that you enjoy Veni, Veni, Emmanuel. Thank you so much. So we also have been preparing for a nice long time. This Selections from Cats is our next arrangement. And when I say Selections from Cats, the kids all groan and hold their stomachs because all they're really familiar with is that goofy movie that they made a couple years ago with the CGI cats with the ears that move and the tails are very flowing and Taylor Swift's in it. And so they're kind of skeeved out by the whole Cats thing. But through the wonder of YouTube, I was able to show them how there's actually a beautiful musical that was along long before they made the goofy movie. And how many of these songs really, even though they're silly and the lyrics are kind of quirky and strange based on the poems of T.S. Eliot, they're really some beautiful music with a lot of heart. So I think they've sort of come to love the Selections from Cats, and we're going to perform that for you now. Feel free to sing and dance along. We heard from senior saxophonist Anthony Parsons on that. Thank you, Anthony. And while I'm introducing a senior, I'd like to ask all of our senior members to please stand up and give a quick wave. You can identify our senior members by the flower on their lapel. So senior members, stand up and give a quick wave and say thank you to your folks. Congratulations and thank you. I was just thinking before we got started that this is my 27th winter concert here at Springfield. So that's a very cheap way for me to get applause. Thank you. I'm very grateful to all of you who really rearranged your schedules in order to make tonight happen. I was not counting on having an extended absence last week, as I know many of you are kind of dealing with also. So I'm very grateful that we have a wonderful showing tonight and all of these great musicians to share on stage with you. So we're going to do one more selection with our fabulous symphonic band, and then we're going to turn things over to the jazz band. And at that point, I'm going to ask you to stay because I want you to hear these three wonderful selections from the jazz band. And I'm going to ask the members of the symphonic band to just have a socially distanced seat out in the auditorium if you're not playing in the jazz band. So we're going to finish up with a really challenging selection. And I was mentioning to the students the other day how I'm really very proud of this performance because I think it would have been very easy for us to just kind of lay up and kind of take it easy after all that we've been through, you know, get out some really easy arrangements and just kind of make it happen. But that's not what we did. We kept the rigor high, and the students really worked very hard to produce an excellent and challenging program for you. So we're going to end with a real challenge. This is a circus march by Carl King. You may recognize it from TV and films. This is called Barnum and Bailey's Favorite, and we've got some wild percussion tricks back there with our wild percussionists. And we call it Barnum and Bailey's Fractured Favorite. So please enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you all very, very much. Your symphonic band. Thank you. So we set up in this interesting formation to make our switch over to jazz band very, very easy. So I'm going to invite the members on stage who are not jazz band performers to go have a socially distant seat out in the audience. And jazz band, you guys can come fill the first two rows as we have been at Tuesday night rehearsals. So give us just about 3 minutes. Rhythm section, make sure you got everything you need.
Thank you.
Little hit from Weather Report, composed by Joe Zawinul. That's called Birdland. One more time for your Springfield High School Jazz Band. Whew. That was pretty hot. Very nice. We heard from Kylan Rode on the smoking guitar. Thank you, Kylan. And from senior bass sensation, Max Kelly. So you guys can get into position. We'll get you started here. This is a sort of a funky ballad. It's not quite a ballad. I'm not going to say it's a ballad because then we're going to play it too slow. But it's got sort of a nice funky Grover Washington kind of feel, sort of like Wine Light, if you remember Wine Light from 1970s and early 80s. And this one's called Easy Does It. It is called Easy Does It, right?
Yeah, it's
easy. I've messed it up. I called it like all kinds of different things. But yes, Easy Does It. We're going to feature Caden. Caden's got the flugelhorn. Can you show the flugelhorn? It's sort of like a larger trumpet. It's wrapped a little bit differently. It's got that smooth, mellow sound. We associate the flugelhorn most often with Chuck Mangione. And if we've got any yacht rock fans out there, Chuck Mangione. More of us jazzers, we think about Art Farmer. And also, we're going to hear a lovely flute solo from Lauren Bundy. So we're going to perform Easy Does It. Let me get you guys everything you need. Not too slow. Caden McGonagher on the flugelhorn. And Lauren Bundy on jazz flute. Bravissimo. Okay, guys, brings us to the end of our program this evening. Once again, I appreciate everyone rearranging your schedules, making tonight happen. I like to think it was all worth it because, boy, I heard some great music tonight. So thank you all very, very much for being a great audience. All right, and we're going to finish up. What's the name of this tune again? Oh, yeah, that's right. How could I forget the Pink Panther? So everybody knows, Dennett, Dennett. Well, this is a much funkier take. This is kind of based on a version that was recorded by Bobby McFerrin. And most people know Bobby McFerrin as the guy who did Don't Worry, Be Happy, right? But he's a really super talented musician. He's conducted orchestras. He's toured the world with all sorts of jazz performers, the highest caliber of jazz performers that you can imagine. So we're going to honor Bobby McFerrin with this beautiful arrangement of The Pink Panther, and we hope that you enjoy it. We're going to feature a little bit of a Barry Sax duel between Lucas Hinkey and Micah Bustos. So we can't have any bloodshed. We already agreed that that was not safe to do. However, we're going to really jazz it up, so we hope that you enjoy this version of The Pink Panther. Thank you. Thank you very much, everybody. Your Springfield Township High School Jazz Band. Your Springfield Township High School Symphonic Band. Big thanks to our high school administrative team for making tonight work, and of course our superintendent, our assistant superintendents, everyone who makes music happen at Springfield. Thank you so much. We'll see you in the spring. Thank you.